Hello friends, welcome back to Vashtik channel. This is Vasanthanaik from Kendra Engineering College. So we will continue module 5. In the last video, you must have seen load and store instruction with single register transfer. In this video, we will continue multiple register transfer. Multiple register transfer is especially useful for moving blocks of data around memory, saving and restoring context and stacks. So the multiple register transfer application is moving blocks of data around memory. After studying this multiple register, there is one program, this is very important program, copy content, block of content to memory and memory to register. So we will see the, all those things. So load multiple registers, store multiple registers. So load multiple registers, store multiple registers. Here multiple registers are used for loading and storing. So we know which is pop instruction equivalent to pop and push instruction. This is equivalent to push instruction, right? This is equivalent to push instruction. What it will do? It will store multiple register to memory, and this will load multiple registers from memory. This is nothing but pop instructions, equivalent to pop instructions, right? Okay. So now next, this one. Here we have different addressing modes here also. There we saw pre-index, post-index and all. Here increment after, increment before, decrement after and decrement before. This is the addressing mode. So you have to remember increment after, increment before, decrement after and decrement before. So now, in this example, register R0 is the base register. This is the base register. So you can see here, register R0 is the base register. This is to be updated. Followed by explanation that indicating that register is updated after instruction is executed. And in multiple register, you can see registers are not individually listed. R1 to R3, it contains R1, R2 and R3. In between you are using the character to represent hyphen characters, you can see. Fine. Now first register, after for this one execution, first condition is something like this. This is a pop instruction, right? This is not a push, this is pop instruction. That means it will load the register from memory. It will load the register from memory. Which and all register it will load? R1, R2 and R3 register is loaded. So now memory, what is there? We will see first memory. It will take base address. Base address is this one. Base address is this one. With this base address, it will form the memory location. So with this base address, what is there? 1 is there. Next address, 2 is there. Next address, 3 is there. This will be loaded into the register. This will be loaded into the register. So what is this load multiple register? Increment after. This will be loaded into the register. So you can see R1 is 1, R2 is 2, R3 is 3. After that address is incremented. What is the next address here? Next address is 1C. After 18, 1C will come. 18, if you add 4, 1C will, you will get 1C. 18, 19, 1A, 1B, 1C. So that is the answer. Now, you can see here, initially base register of this one, then it will try to load this from to register from memory. So instruction will load the register from here, 1, 2, 3. This is the content is loaded. Initially you can see register R1, R2, R3, 0, 0, 0. After the execution, R1, R2, R3, 1, 2, 3. And Next, R0 is updated with the next location. R0 is updated with next location. This is the one instruction. Second instruction is load multiple register, increment before. Increment before. Now you see, same content will take increment before. So now, so in increment before, first it will increase the base register by 4. Now base register will come after incrementation, register will get updated with this one, this address. Now it will ignore this location, earlier base register location, and from the next location it will start loading R1, R2, R3. You see the difference between first case and the second case, increment before. And in the first case, you will get this address after execution. You will get this address for the base register. Here, base register will get this address first itself, and it will start loading this location, not this location. So this is increment before. So similarly, we have decrement after and decrement before. So you have to remember from the exam point of view, increment after is equal to decrement before is equal to decrement after is equal to increment before, all these informations. And here one example is given, increment instructions STMIB. Is equal to LDMDA, increment before is equal to decrement after. How in the exam they may ask, show STMIB is equal to LDMDA. I have explained this one. You have to remember this one, and you have to you have to study this one, and you have to write this one. So if you have any doubt, you can get back to me. This is very, very important. Please remember. So try to apply the logic and get back to me if you face problem this one. So here STMIB in between STMIB and LDMDA there are three stages: free condition 2 and forced condition. So you can see here instructions are something like this: STMIB R0 R1 R3. After that LDMDA R0 R1 R3. So R1 value is this one. So after execution of both the instruction, this is the condition. Please remember this one. Now, so from exam point of view, this load store multiple instructions can be used to copy block of data to memory. So how this can be done? We can see here R1 points to start of source address, R10 points to start of destination, R11 point to end of the source. And how we can use the instruction, this we'll see here. Before that, we'll move to first one here. Here you can see this content should be copied from here to here. So our source address is in R9. And source end address is in R11. Destination starts in R10. I know my source content that has to be copied to destination, and destination address is in R10 register. So now you see here, first loop is there anyway. Load M means load the load means pop instruction, equivalent to pop instruction, right? Load the multiple register, increment after. After that, you increment it. So, starting from base address R9, These registers are loaded, R0 and R7 registers are loaded. R0 and R7 registers are loaded. Now it is push instruction. Store that in this address, and address is also incremented after that one. Compare now. After storing, compare whether R9 is equivalent to R11. R9 is equivalent to R11. If both are equal, R9 and R11, R9 is equivalent to R11, then it means we reached at the end. If not equal, loop. If it is equal, then come out from the loop. So this instruction is to copy 32, value from one area to other area. From exam point of view, very important five instructions. And you have to write this diagram also. So in the stack also, here stack operation also, stack uses pop operation and push operation, basing data onto the stack, push operation, removing data from the stack, pop operation, load multiple instruction, store multiple instruction. Stack is either a temporary memory, so here stack works in ascending and descending. Stack grows towards higher memory, stack grows towards lower memory. And here also full ascending, full descending, empty ascending and empty descending, four options are there. So as I said in earlier case, so you can see here STMD, store multiple register with the full descending instruction pushes the register onto the stack, updating the SP. So figure shows the push onto full descending stack. So here you can see these are the empty stack, empty area. Here pushes the data and the stack is updated. So stack pointer is updated. So now we have one more instruction here. So this is store multiple full descending. Same thing. So full descending R1, R2, R3, R4. Is stored into stack pointer and stack pointer is updated. You can see here stack pointer is updated after this one. Similarly, we have store multiple so empty descending. So empty descending, you can see the difference here, empty descending. So it will store this order. Here stack pointer is there, it will store this order, but in the descending order, but you can see here the stack pointer is pointing to this address later. In the earlier case, in the address is in the ascending order. So here you can see stack pointer is updated with this one, empty. Here it is not like that. So you can check one program for Stack Overflow also. So this is the program for Stack Overflow. Next type of instruction is swap instruction. Swap instruction is special case of load and store instruction. Swap the content of memory with the content of register. A instruction is automatic operation. It reads and writes the location in the same bus operation, preventing other instruction from loading or writing into location. So we have swap instruction SWP and a swap byte instruction. You can see here. Swap instruction. The swap instruction loads the words from memory into register R0 and overwrites the memory with the register R1. So this is the memory, this is the content, this is the status of R0, R1. What it will do, swap R0, R1, R2. So don't think like it will swap R1 and R2. So it will copy So it will copy a memory location. This is the memory location. See, you can see this is the memory location, R2. What is R2 here? This one. With the content of R1. And it will load R0 with the content of that memory location. So now R0 is loaded with this one. R1 is copied to this one. So please remember here, R1 is copied to, R1 content goes to this location. And R2 content goes to this one. Normally we'll swap means we'll think R1 and R2 are exchange something like this. No. R1 content goes to R2. R2 content goes to R0. You have to remember this one. This is called as a swap. So swap instruction example, you have to write this. You can write this one. So swap instructions are used in semaphore. So example for semaphore, you can see here. Next, last two instruction, set of instruction, last two set of instructions are there. Software instructions. Software instruction causes software interrupt exception, which provides a mechanism for application to call operating system routines. You know, I told there are six privilege mode, and one is user mode, and we have system mode. User mode and system mode you have seen. So software interrupt instructions, whenever you assume that your mobile is in user mode, you want to install some application app, then that time it goes to system mode. That time it will execute software interrupt instruction. So causes the software interrupt exception, which provides a mechanism for application to call operating system routine. So you can see a software interrupt instruction with the software interrupt number, that time address of the instruction following SWI, then SPR SVC is equal to SVC is equal to CPSR, PC vectors is equal to PC is equal to vectors plus 8 location aid, CPSR mode is supervisor mode, then CPSR1 is equal to I, all this information you have to remember. When the processor executes the software instruction, it assigns the program counter to offset 8. Instruction also processes the processor mode to SVC, which allows operating system routine to be called in a privilege mode. Here is a simple example of SW call with SW number used by ARM toolkits as a debugging. You can see CPSR condition PC. After this one, what is the condition of PC? What is the condition of LR? All these informations are here. Last one is a program status register instruction. Program status register instruction. There are two type of instructions are there. MRS instruction and MSR instruction. MRS instruction transfer the contents of either CPSR or SPSR into register. That is just like a backup of these registers. Then MSR instruction transfer the content of register into CPSR and SPSR. So you can see here the format of MRS and MSR. So it will copy the MRS, copy the program status register to general purpose register. MSR move a general purpose register to program status register. MSR move a immediate value into program status register. So these are the done by this one. So you can see here on program is there. MSR first copies CPSR into register RS1. Here you can see MRS copies register to R1. The BIC instruction clears the bit 7 of R1. Now our BIC instruction will clear the bit 7 of R1. Then copied back to CPSR. So clearing the bit 7 of R1 when you copy that to CPSR, what it will do actually? It will you can see this will preserve all the other settings and only modifies the I bit in the control field. This will modify only I bit in the control field. That means it will take you to interrupt mode. This will take you to interrupt mode, I bit. What is I bit? You know, I bit is interrupt and F bit is the fast interrupt. All those things are there. Coprocessor instruction are used to extend the instruction set. A coprocessor can either provide additional computational capability. Coprocessor instruction include data processing instruction, digital transfer and memory transfer instruction. All those things are there. So we have a couple of coprocessor instructions: CDP, MRC, MCR, LDC and HCC. So these are the coprocessor instruction and how coprocessor register can be copied. This is the instruction you have to remember. So with this friends, I have tried to complete module 5. Some of the instructions are there. So if we go in detail, students will get confused here. So let me conclude here only. Module 5, this from exam point of view, this much is sufficient. So please go through it. So if you need doubt, you can mail me, or you can ping me. Thank you.